one word. Max Leiter!
Hello. I know it's been a while, like 2 months since I made a video, and I'm sorry. There's a few reasons why I haven't made a video. The first reason is because I'm just incredibly lazy. I'm gonna try and go off of these notes that I wrote a while ago when I was planning on making this video, update video, and I just never got around to it. The other reason is that just looking back on how things have been going, I've probably been in a depression of varying degrees since October or November of last year, and then I probably had a mixed episode around January, and then on top of that they changed my hours at work yet again, and now I'm going in at 1 a.m. and I am basically always tired. I haven't quite adjusted to the schedule. I'm trying different ways of sleeping so that I can get to work and spend time with my family and just work on some other things that I'm supposed to be working on. I don't know. So one of the things I wanted to talk about was just how therapy was going, and it's going well. I'm still going every week. Still working on my bipolar, one with psychotic features, and she hasn't really diagnosed me with anything else. I don't quite know how that would work or how that works, but she does talk a lot about social anxiety. I don't know if she would diagnose that as a something separate or just as, you know, something that is common with bipolar disorder. And then another thing, which she, again, there's been no diagnosis, but it's something that when I explain to her things that are going on, things that I do and things that I think and things that I feel, I've often mentioned it, is OCD, but again, no diagnosis on that. And as far as what we're doing with bipolar, we're doing a lot of mood monitoring, my sleep and eating habits, which are just not that good. But we're monitoring all that and also doing some thought monitoring. And with social anxiety, we're concentrating on getting me to leave my room, the box here, and going to places where I would normally go and interact with people. And also trying to understand why and where the anxiety comes from. The CBT book talks about finding core self-beliefs. And I'll talk about one or two of those maybe in another video. Just what it feels like is that I'm just dredging up all this old stuff that I had thought I had worked through it at some point. But what I'm now realizing that I've been doing is I just think about those things, and I just think over and over and replay them, ruminating on them over and over in my head. And that over time, I have created some bad coping skills so that I can hide from them, run from them, or just ignore them. And so now I'm honestly sitting down and facing them, and then combating the thoughts and feelings that come with them. And basically, after I leave therapy, sometimes I feel pretty down, just worn out. My psychiatrist has even told me that sometimes therapy can be hard, and if you need to take a break, that you just tell your therapist, hey, I'm not going to come next week or the next couple weeks, and they usually listen to that. But the good thing is I do have a clear idea of the things that are going on in my head, and I also, you know, have ways to deal with them that push me forward and not have me stay where I am. Although I will say, something happened personally in my life with my family that kind of, the doctor said, I kind of backslid, and I kind of reverted back to some of the old things that I was doing. But you know, that's life, so I have to find a way to move forward. I'm also trying to step out of my comfort zone, which is difficult because I'm uncomfortable everywhere. So I'm doing little things like going to get the mail, which is very stressful for me. I'm trying to learn to be present and not put on a face when I'm around others. Again, I might explain some of that in another video, but other than that, I am, there's not been much else, except after ECT, I thought that I was done with delusions and hallucinations, and I've started having things happen where I've been, just seeing some things and occasionally hearing some things, and I talked to my doctors about it, and they basically both said that once you've had like a psychotic episode, it is not unusual for you to have like residual psychosis that comes in every now and again. So that was nice to hear and fun to experience. So that's it for me. Everything else is pretty cool, fine, whatever. Love, peace.
I don't wanna ride a crowded subway, I wanna go by